Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I am Zachariah1688, and I just want to go ahead and put this little forward in front of the video, or over the video, however the case may be, for whichever video it is. If you're watching this, it has definitely already been previously recorded for quite a long time now. It's just a little backup footage I had, or maybe it's the next one in the series. I don't know which video it is. It's kind of a catch-all. But just letting you know, if I'm not responding to anything you're posting on YouTube, or if you are noticing that there was something posted, say, a couple days ago to even a week ago, that just now popped up in your feed from my channel, it is because I am not there to make it active and live on the spot. So I am putting everything up for at least 2 weeks worth, hopefully at least 2 weeks worth of videos on my channel now. And I'm going to publish it and make it live on the day that it happens. Thank goodness for the miracles of smartphones. But anyway, the case for this is I just have some business I need to attend to, which is out of state from where I live. And as soon as this business is done, publishing will be back as usual. But I'm putting this in front of every video just to let you know. Hey, you know, just come by if there's a section of a series that you're really into, or if there's a video of mine that you're really into, that you're wanting to watch, that you haven't noticed pop up in your publisher's feed, it's probably because I loaded it up early and published it late. I don't have that, what is the thing that the regular YouTube partners, because I'm doing this for free. God, I know, I'm stupid. But anyway, what is that thing that regular YouTube partners get is the allow to pretty much pre-program entire series. Like, they can upload everything and just have it regularly scheduled to go out. I think that's what YouTube partners get. I don't get it. Whatever. It doesn't bother me any. But, yeah. So, this is that little, like, this is what's going on. Hope you enjoy the video anyway. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you like it. Hopefully you sub. And I will see you as soon as I get back. I'm trying to make sure that you guys still get videos, even though I'm gone, though. So, but yeah. Enjoy the video. And have a great and wonderful day. All right, here we are. Kind of trying to hold the high ground here a little bit. Holding this ridge right here for the most part. But not going too close to the woods because I want them to be out of that cover whenever they attack me. I don't want to be fighting an enemy in cover at all. They have all deployed. They have all been nice enough to deploy completely into my firing arc. So we're going to take both of these. You. Fire on them. You. Fire on them. Bit of horse guard coming in. Got a lot of horse coming in. So anyway, what I'm hoping to be able to do is catch them completely off guard with these troops in the tall grass, and the Republican Guard and this cavalry in the tall grass. They can't see these units at all. They can't see these units at all. They can still see my 1st Delaware, however. I tried putting every single unit I could in the grass, and that's how I found out which units would hide. If all my units could hide, we'd be bunched up more or less right here. We're gonna hold this ridge. This is gonna be the battle for the ridge, more or less. And we you're setting the woods on fire. That is a really nice shot. I mean, look at that. That looks really nice. I like that a lot. It's really cool. And then heavies. Switch to there we go. Switch to round. Increase your range, therefore you're effective. Oh, they're all in a line. They're all in a column. Get those troops in. Oh, they're gonna run away. Oh, that's probably the general's unit. And that would be why they're running away. Alright. Did I tell them? Yeah, I told everyone who's hiding that can fire to hold their fire. I don't want that to become too much. Like, I don't want them to just like open fire and lose our element of surprise that we have, which I am grateful for having. Throw your hellfire onto those guys. See what happens. Oh, we've already opened fire over here. They're scouting, so they know I have way more troops deployed than I actually do. Let's go ahead and give them them, but not the infantry. But let them see them, that's okay. Do not give them the infantry. Okay, they haven't been found out yet. Okay, good. Rest that cav. Deploy. Get ready for another formal. Fire out my mother over there. It is not coming back. Crap. They got found out though. They go back to hiding. It's okay. Them now. Go back to group one. Meet them in the middle of the field. Adjust your fire. Fire what I told you to. Adjust your fire, battalion. What are you doing? Oh, crap, Ola. Well, both the Republican Guard units got found up, of course. Part of that's my fault, but mostly the cavalry, good lord. They just would not listen to orders. I told them to attack, and they're like, okay, we're gonna go in formation over here. We completely decimated that entire cavalry unit. That I'm okay with. There we go. Come at me, Danes. Let's do this. Let's do this. Come on. Come at me. Why are we disheveled here? That is why we're disheveled. Receiving already fire. Okay. Go here. Open up on them. Crap, they're still in the tree line. I was hoping to be able to avoid having it in the tree line when they start firing it. You know what? I feel like being bold and adventurous. Let's do this. What are we going against for Hardy? Like, what are they throwing at us, Hardy-wise? Howitzers. Oh, 24-pounder howitzers. And horse Hardy. Yeah, no. We're not putting up with that today. There, you there, and you there. Back to the actual fight. See how this is turning up. Yeah, see? Good, that also distracted a few of them. Coming at me across the entire front I have developed for myself here. So, you fire on the ones further. Ooh, man, that's loud. You fire the ones close to the heart, as it were. Limbering up at all? Getting them? No, it's almost like they don't even notice the art. Ooh, hello, spikes. Did not see you there. Here we go. Oh, this is developing. That is a beautiful formation I have here. It's working very well. A lot better than I thought it would, not gonna lie. How are we doing on ammo? Everybody looks really good on ammo. Let's go to that horse. No, come back. What are you doing? Come back. Clear the spikes. Good. And here's where the pain happens. Ooh. Now some of them are going to run into the spikes, and because... Oh wow, we didn't lose that many to the spikes. I'm surprised. I guess running with spikes is a lot easier than running against spikes. Did not know they had programmed that into the game. Who would have figured? Let's take the 3rd Brigade, actually. Deploy you here. Oh, no. Pull on here. Thank you. Take the... Is this the Delaware? Yeah, 1st Delaware. Throw the Delaware out here as an element. A flanking prevention element. Fire on them. Fire on them. You fire on them. You switch to round, increase your range, fire on them. Do we leave? Yep, they're already is done for. Good. I believe that is a victory for us today. Okay, here we go with the after battle report. I had the numerical advantage there, but there was no reason for them to have lost damn near, if not 3/4 of their forces. Only lost a little over 300. Not bad. So not bad for them for to inflict that upon me, but it's not much of a fight, truth be told. Alright, so that entire army's dead, which means down to just the one unit of troops.
Here we are with the next turn.
The winter of 1805, we've had Afghanistan destroyed, and we've had Westphalia destroyed. Traits gained. Townsend. John Sullivan. Oh, that's the general who is taking Hanover. Most of my recruitment's going on over here. We'll come back to the mainland in just a few. Kind of miss seeing the American coast. Got used to it. Alright, let's go here.
For battle.
And we're just going to auto-resolve this. There we go. That kicks Russia out of this territory. Doesn't it? Yes, it does. There's some the Danish Navy. Let's go ahead and deal with that.
For country, for home, and for the prize. We are victorious.
Go ahead and add that. What is that? 6-3. That, why not? Add that to the fleet. Alright, and
your humble servant.
Go here.
For battle.
Auto resolve.
Proud and victorious.
Wipe all those troops out. Sweden. Now here's the biggie.
Siege work underway.
Go here. Of course, surrender's refused. I'm going to auto resolve this because kind of hard for us not to win. Fingers crossed. Seen worse happen with the auto-resolve.
We are mighty and unbowed!
And I didn't lose a single unit, although some of my units got really, really low. Okay.
Battalion ready!
Should be goodbye to Denmark. Yes, it is. Now Prussia cannot just march through Hanover. What we're going to do is we're going to do what we normally do when it comes to stuff like this. We're going to beef up Hanover, talk to the French, see if they want to trade Hanover for... I haven't gotten to it yet. I've been trying to tease it, see if you notice on the mini-map. Look who London belongs to now. That happened last turn. This is kind of why I'm glad I didn't keep fighting the Prussians, because those full-stack armies just mow over things, especially when they're Prussian armies. So anyway, we're going to go here, heal everybody up. It's going to take a little while.
Egg ready.
I'm just going to throw you into... Oh, it's a steam dry dock. Sweet. Throw you into there. We're keeping Denmark just because of the school, really. That's the only reason we're keeping Copenhagen. I want the school to be able to go ahead and get those techs. And we're going to beef up and... pretty much, what's the real estate term? Flip it? Flip the property, or something like that, where you take an old junky property and make it look nice, and you flip it and you sell it for double what you got it for. It's basically what we're going to do, but we're going to be trading off, oh, this is part of Sweden. No, that's cool. It's ours now. Awesome. We're going to be trading it for territories in the Americas. So let's go ahead and go here. Sweden was burning to the ground. Holy crap. That's going to cost too much. Are you going to cost too much? Of course you are. Okay. Alright.
Orders, Captain.
And you're kind of damaged, so we will bring you port to repair.
Any orders?
And we will call that turn for here. Okay, here we are. The summer of 1806. Is that Eastport? Or no, it's here. Okay. Turn this into... I really have another commercial port, to be honest. Ooh. Hmm. Okay. Doesn't bother me any. Let's go here. Oh, the palatial estates. Oh, the slavery. I mean, all the plantations. And still folks have a vision of slavery. Anyway. So we're making maximum food product here. Can I get this yet? Not quite. How close am I to getting that engine? 5 turns. Oh, Uppsala has a school too. It's your citizenship. I want to get all this as fast as possible. Abolition of slavery. Ooh, that's probably a reason. That might start a civil war, I'm not gonna lie. Within my own territories, if we go ahead and grab that tech. Which I would be against fighting, but just not sure if it's the time to go ahead and do that. Alright, so we still have to worry about. Oh, yeah, let's talk to. Let's go ahead and talk to France about getting Upper Louisiana from them. Negotiations. Regions. Give me Upper Louisiana, if you would please. Yeah, because I don't care about either one of those, and I will be happy to trade you Hanover for that territory. I'll even pay you, say, 10,000. 10,000 sounds good. And what about military access? I've already given you indefinite military access. Okay. Let's go ahead and send that. Crap. France, I don't want to have to go to war with you, but I will. Not afraid of it, my friend. Not afraid of it at all. Who are your allies? Spain, Italian states, and Venice. Actually, I kind of hope we go to war. Because if Spain jumps in that, I can go ahead and grab Texas and New Mexico, and that will leave Great Britain to deal with for territories that I need. Great Britain and the Chickasaw. Yeah, we heard about New France. I mean, we heard about London. Sorry about that. We know you're on harsh times, which is why we're going to offer Hanover and Sweden to you, because you've also lost Scotland, for goodness sakes. We'll give you those two territories, and we'll pay you. We're probably going to counter this with saying, become our military allies, please. Let's go to 15,000. Yeah. Here. Crap! The game just locked up for the longest time, so they were seriously considering it. Oh, man. Well, England, I can and will go to war with you for those territories, but not just yet. You are losing your ass, though. I mean, you're clinging on to North America because you have India, and that's it. Alright, let's go to the Cherokee, then, and offer to dump Hanover to the Cherokee for Florida. Regions. I want Florida. I'll give you Hanover. And I'll also pay you, let's say, 18,000. And we'll give you military access for 10 turns. No, I think that's an amazing deal. Okay. Fine. I guess it is gonna. Oh, wait, hold on. They're not allied with the British anymore. Did not notice this. Ooh. Why didn't you guys tell me? Probably have. For a few episodes. Alright, let's take this army minus the Rangers. March them to here. Take this army, go ahead and put a few of you guys here just for keeping the peace. March to here.
By the left.
Anything more?
Still dirt roads in Louisiana. Alright, so take that, take Florida, wipe the Cherokee off the map, go ahead and take Kaintuck, which will leave. Oh man, I can go into is are the Maratha still allied to Great Britain? Crap, yes. If the Cherokee can convince the Maratha to go to war with me, then I can use that to grab Kaintuck, quickly declare a peace with the Maratha. This might work. But to see if it does work, we're going to have to wait till next time. I'll see you all later. You all have a wonderful day. And, yeah. Long live the American Empire.